Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Happy Harvest Homestead. In this video, I'm going to be breeding angora rabbits. In this cage, we have my French angora doe, Sequoia, and then we're going to be breeding her today to Lucky, my French angora buck. One of them. So, this is the first time Sequoia is being bred, and I hope it's the first time Lucky is breeding someone. He might have accidentally bred with Charity, our English angora doe, through the bars of his cage, but hopefully he didn't, so we'll have to see how that plays out. But it's supposedly both their first time doing it, but I've been breeding rabbits for quite a while, so I'm sort of going to walk you through what you're supposed to, like what's supposed to happen and what it looks like and how you know if it works or not. And I'm just gonna warn you before we start that this video is a breeding video, so if you don't wanna, I'm gonna like be showing the breeding part, so if you don't wanna see that, then maybe pick a different video. So now that you've been sufficiently warned, it's time to get to the breeding part. So one of the first rules of breeding rabbits is that you always, if they're in cages that is that you always take the girl to the boy's cage. Does can be very territorial and they might hurt the buck, and even if they don't, the buck sometimes just likes to sniff around and doesn't really get the job done. Hello! Don't jump out, please. So, we're gonna bring Sequoia to Lucky's cage, but before we do that, I'm gonna take out his food and water and stuff so that it doesn't get tipped over while they're being bred. So I've just put them in, and right away he's, oh, all right, I might close this. So right now, it's kind of hard to see, but I have to keep the door closed or she tries to jump out. He's chasing her around and she's running away. I think this is called circling, and it's pretty usual. So they've been doing it for a little bit, and so we'll see. All right, so now, what we're looking for is him to mount up on her. He's mounting on her, and yes, it worked. So he mounted up on her, and then he sort of grunted and snorted, and if they just wiggle a lot, he's trying. And so he, look at her. So she's in the right position, her head is down, her ears are back, and her tail's lifted up. He mounted on her, and then he shook for a long time, and then he snorted and fell off. When they fall off, that means they were bred. So we usually like to, most people like to see at least two or three fall offs to make sure they're bred. If your doe doesn't want to be bred, she'll be running away more and maybe climbing the walls or like tucking her bum into the corner so that she can't be bred, but she obviously did. So that was very fast and easy and awesome, and Lucky is a great buck. He wasn't, like sometimes they'll try to mount the wrong side or something, but he got right down to business. So let's see if we can get a second fall off. Usually, with a lot of my rabbits, you can get two really fast, like with the first fall off and then the second one, then you have to wait a while for the third. So, let's see. She's running around again, and he's chasing her again. I'm gonna try to have her so that she doesn't jump off now. So, she should lay down with her ears back and her head to the cage floor, and her bottom sort of like lifted up a little bit. Now he's just licking her, which is kind of gross, but that's what they do. So they're back to circling. People have had successful litters, like there have been successful litters with only one fall off, but a lot of people like to at least get two, so I'm hoping for three and I'll be okay with two. I've had some rabbits have as many as five fall offs, and I don't think it really affects. The number of fall-offs doesn't really affect the number of babies you have, and people have had like huge litters with one fall-off. I just want to make sure she's pregnant, so I'm gonna at least hope for two. So he's trying. Let's see. So he was wiggling a lot and he was trying, and then when he stopped and snorted and fell over, that was a successful one. If they keep just wiggling and wiggling and trying, that means it's not working. And then they thump sometimes. So that was the second fall-off, and so I could take her right now, but I'm just gonna leave her in and see if we can get a third. Oh, and then sometimes they give kisses. Isn't that so cute? Now he's mounting her head. He is a first-time buck, so this isn't a surprise, but isn't that funny? He's trying. I don't think she's letting up for him. She's sort of smashing the corner and her head's up and stuff. Let's see if we can get a third fall off. Let's see. So before, let's see if you can get a better look. Before she was sort of like up, but now she's sort of like down. Let's see if he can do it. Let's see. You can do it. Nope. Not good enough for you. She isn't lifting. I have to lift, girly. I want the babies. So he's trying, but it's not working. Come on. So now I have to decide, do I stop with two? Because she's probably pregnant. Probably. Or do I wait? I could wait for one more, but she doesn't seem to be lifting. So if she continues to not lift for him, maybe I'll put her in again tomorrow, or just leave it like this because she's probably already bred. Just saw her tail. It was down, and then I saw it. It was like sort of like that, and then it went whoop. And see how she sort of crouched, and her ears are back, and her head is down. If you did it, bud, I think she'd be good. And sometimes if the doe is just not staying still, you can sort of hold her down, like hold her head, but notice how her tail is down. Can you see that? Yeah. It's like down. It should be up like that. Someone's given up. He's done. He just flopped. He's like, I give up. So maybe I'll take her back now. So Sequoia is back in her cage. I think two is enough, and we'll see in a few weeks how many babies she has, or if she has any at all. So keep a lookout for that video. Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and maybe learned something, and let me know in the comments how your rabbit breedings go. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!